The most compelling thing I've managed to do so far with one of these cameras was to take interior pictures of every room in my house
right.
that I'm currently trying to sell. Call me for details. And actually,
disclaimer
at the bottom, the value of my property is probably going down as we speak.
I assure you.
Yes, it's the Friday of the referendum. We should make note for the camera. Because actually, one fundamental thing and one less expected thing. The less expected thing was that actually the intimacy of each one of those rooms, where I just put the camera on the tripod in the middle, actually meant that I was really genuinely interested in looking around, even at my own house, which clearly I didn't see with my own eyes, but made for actually quite an interesting experience, because I could see every aspect of that room without having to rely on a clever wide-angle shot being taken by the photographer.
What's quite interesting for me, and hopefully for young people growing up and media grads that are coming through university now, this is all brand new. There is no template for how to do this. There's no people that are there going, I've been doing VR 20 years, I know exactly what works.
Sure.
You literally will have to choreograph 360 scenes if you're producing that music video or that movie. Mm-hmm. And thinking in an entirely different way from a whole generation of creators of content.
Absolutely.
That's pretty exciting, right? Because I think they will start to come up with stuff we haven't even thought of now. How do you drag people into that scene? How do you represent a story in 360 when somebody can decide to look in the opposite direction of a conversation?
Exactly. So a director traditionally has been the guidance almost through the imaginative scene that is set by either the television show or the movie, because you look at whatever he or she points the camera at, and then the story that unfolds in that shot is then the craft of the actors and the costume designers, etc.
Yeah.
Here, it's you're making me think of the old choose your own adventure books in a way. If I can turn to any page in the book at any point I want, how on earth do you make a cohesive story?
But I think that lends itself to the close-up as well. So I think if you're directing a 360 video, the closer you are to the action, and I guess this is a guess as much as anything, is you're going to be able to control it more. If you're in a close-up scene in a room and there's a fire in the room, we're naturally, our eyes are drawn to this type of stuff, right?
Yeah, sure.
And that will become part of the magic of filmmaking and being able to tell a story within a 360 environment.
It does feel like a fundamental change in the way that creators are invited to then make content, because it's not just being cognizant of an audience, playing to an audience, but it's potentially putting the audience at the very epicenter of the narrative and the way it's shot, which leads to a very different kind of first-person experience for audiences.
Well, it's literally a first-person experience. And that's where I think there's a lot of power in that. There's a lot of power in the idea of first-person shooter games, Call of Duty, Doom, Quake, all those other games that now cause me to show my age by mentioning Quake or Doom or Wolfenstein. Because that notion that you put yourself inside the eyes of the player is very powerful. Of course, with gaming, you're accustomed to choosing the direction and the action of what you do. So this is almost like a halfway house between being able to choose that direction, but not necessarily able to choose the actual action that goes
on. You're still inside
a static.
Correct. You're talking about the difference between video and effectively a three-dimensional environment, more of the gaming side, where you're free to walk around and choose where you go.
So Oculus, PlayStation, VR, Vive, etc. have the element of both directional viewing and control, and therefore will lend themselves immediately to games and quite possibly to another format.
Yeah.
A device like this, we are suggesting, might de facto need a simpler format because it's not as immersive
as the immediate presentation
suggested it is. Exactly, you're on rails, that's a good way of putting it. You're watching something on a VR headset that you know isn't real, but is so real that you are aware that your brain is being fooled by it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's like being consciously hypnotized.
It's the holodeck on Star Trek.
It's the holodeck on Star Trek.
It's not real, but it's good enough.
It's not real.
It's
not real, but it's the fact that you know it isn't real, yet are consciously participating in it, that actually creates some of the compelling nature, I think. It's partly like an unknown, but let's face it, all drugs and narcotics to some degree are about trying to put yourself into a different state.